exceptions of Southwest, ended up in bankruptcy or very close to bankruptcy. At the end of the day, analytics is a very powerful tool. There is no two ways about that. But it is no compromise for having a sustainable business model. Analytics cannot be a source of long-term sustainable competitive advantage. It can never replace gut feeling of a Jack Welch. It can never replace the insight of a Warren Buffett. It can never replace the vision of a Ratan Tata. And this is something every decision maker, right from the CEO to the analytics manager, has to understand. How do you make the best use of analytics? Yet, at the same time, you do not miss out on the bigger picture, the picture of the macro environment. What kind of business model are you operating? Does analytics even make sense? Today, in India, if you look at it, analytics is used in quite a major way by financial services firms. However, at the end of the day, a firm can only justify its existence the day the customer sees value. And to create that customer value, a firm will have to always ensure that its ear is to the ground and it is always in a position to ensure that it does not take its customer for granted. In fact, over here, I would like to quote the example of Dell. Dell's competitive advantage, its USP, is not technology. I mean, there are players like Apple who have better technology, better design products. There are players like HP and IBM who have the reach which Dell did not have. Yet, at the end of the day, Dell turned out to be the PC player with the most highest ROE in the US PC industry for the simple reason that they were very clear about what kind of customer segment they are focusing on. They are very clear about what kind of business model they were focusing on. And they ensured from day one that they would provide a customer service which was way ahead of what the industry could offer through the direct selling model. And over here, you don't require analytics. And once again, to reiterate, at the end of the day, analytics is a business tool, but it is no substitute for judgment, intuition, and experience. Thank you.
Good morning, friends. I'm Sandeep Majumdar. I've got around 6 years of experience in IT industry. I would like to counteract my friend Vijay on the points he have mentioned. The points which I can take up, had given two examples. One was the example of the airlines industry, and he mentioned the ROIs of the various industries that has not been able to utilize the analytics application. I think he himself mentioned that the airlines industry were running on an obsolete business model. So when United and American Airlines were investing in supply chain analytics, Southwest Airlines were looking on for the low cost factor. So the United and American Airlines was not working in sync with their business model and what they are trying to do through the technology. So this is why they failed. Whereas Southwest Airlines had a specific business model in mind, they were working on a low cost model and they harnessed on that. They worked on the technology as well and they succeeded. So, and on the ROI part, I think Vijay mentioned that there is no sustainable competitive advantage as well as ROI which can be generated through the analytics application. I beg to differ his point. If you see, a technology research firm, IDC, had done a research in which they tried to find out what kind of ROI the analytics application can generate. The numbers are stunning. A focus on CRM analytics gives you an ROI of approximately 155%. Similarly, a focus on financial management or analytics on financial management gives you an ROI of 139%. Similarly, the stress on production analytics will give you a stunning ROI return of 277%. So all such examples clearly say that if you invest in analytics and you have got the best of minds behind it, definitely you are bound to have a competitive advantage. And if you see other examples also, we have seen Capital One, the example which Sindhu took, their stock price increased by more than 1,000%. It was because of the proper business minds which came into the picture, and of course the technological advantage through analytics they got. It is a combination of both. Analytics just cannot go just on a single means way. It has to be a combination of both the leadership as well as the technology you are using. If you take the example of Marriott Hotels, they use the revenue management and the use of predictive analytics to predict the hotel occupancy rates, and they saw their revenues increasing from 83 to 91% in just a matter of 1 or 2 years. They were also given the status of most admired company in the Fortune magazine for approximately more than 7 years. So we have got multiple examples like this. I would also like to take that example which Alka gave. It was Google. I think Google is surviving on analytics right now. Their concept like AdSense, these are like, means it has changed the name of the game in the business paradigm. So we have got multiple examples. And finally, if we need to, we need to improve on the fact that we need to generate ROI and all. We need to have a proper leadership, proper business skills in practice. And maybe leaders like Jack Welch and Warren Buffett are outliers. Specifically, as Taleb had mentioned, there will always be outliers. But if you go by the general trend in the industry, there will be leaders and they always go by numbers. I just like to end, means like, there is like, there is a quote, everybody goes through data, means, but ultimately the numbers survive. That's it.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Manish Sharma, and I come with an experience of 5 years in the banking and financial sector. And I'm going to speak against the motion. Now, let me first define what analytics is. Providing too much data to decision maker rather than making 4 bullet points. That is called analytics. Just to give you an example of analytics. Suppose I say to someone that I and Michael Jordan have won 6 NBA championships. This is analytics. They won't say that Michael Jordan has won 6 and I have won 0 is equal to 6. That is called analytics. Now, just to take the lead from what Sandeep said regarding ROI, if analytics was such a great thing and were able to increase the ROI, what about the financial crisis, subprime crisis? Banks like finance, Lehman Brothers, who were recruiting the most brilliant people all over the world, land up in bankruptcy. They were having the best of models. If analytics were such a great thing, why couldn't it save Lehman Brothers or the subprime crisis or the Great Depression for that matter? At the end of the day, it's the gut feeling of the leader which matter rather than the data, because data is, can be gathered from different sources. And as Vijay rightly said, analytics is just a glorified version of Excel. Just to give you some examples, one of the greatest CEO of our time, Mr. Jack Welch, he invested in China when China was going through rough times. It was, if I remember it correctly, Mao Zedong era. And he said over there while investing that it is my instinct, and I mean, I'm investing in China based on my instinct and not on the basis of figure. As was in the case of Mexico, when Mexico was going to the bankruptcy, he invested somewhere around $17 billion over there. Now let me come to the stock market, since I am from banking and financial sector. George Soros, as you everyone know, there's no need to define George Soros. He started his career in quantum fund, and he started the quantum fund in banking sector. And people at that point of time were giving him data that banking sector, if you invest in banking sector, you don't have future. But now George Soros is a history. Everyone knows who is George Soros. Let me add some more points today. I believe it's the simplicity of the business model that matter rather than analytics or any other analyst tool. If I can give an example of Indian company, Mumbai Dhabawalas, what analytics do they follow? It's just simple, basic business. The business process, the simplicity of the business model, it looks complicated to us, but at the end of the day, they don't have any analytic tool, but they are a Six Sigma company. And few of our very big companies, I won't name the company name because few of us where you are representing out here are not, unfortunately not a Six Sigma company. I would also like to give you an example of the writer Malcolm Gladwell, who in his book Blink has mentioned that it's the gut feeling of the reader which matters. I think one of our friends has told the name of Ratan Tata. Take the example of Ratan Tata for that matter, or J.R.D. Tata, or Warren Buffet, Rakesh Jhunjhunwala, Ramdev Agarwal. They have invested at that point of time when the data were against it. Rakesh Jhunjhunwala invested in Titan when nobody gave Titan any priority. Now, Rakesh Jhunjhunwala makes 5,000, he is the empire of 5,000 crores. And before investing, as a management student or as a business reader, you must associate the cost behind it. What is the cost that I am incurring while investing any analytic tool? For that matter, SAS, SAS, SPSS, or other tool. What is the cost and what is the return I'm getting? If you want to implement SAS, say, if you want to buy a student model, you have to pay 1 million just to have a student version. So you can just imagine the kind of cost you have to incur to get the data. And as we just said, will it improve your bottom line or top line? I really doubt. I would like to end the motion by saying that analytics is a tool which can help you improve your decision, but just depending on analytics that it will help you improve your bottom line, top line is a myth. It's the gut feeling of the reader, because at the end of the day, analytics provide you, suppose you implement this, an executive goes to the CEO and says, sir, if you invest this, the chances are 49.0000, it would be failure, and 50.9999, it would be a success. Now, the CEO takes the decision on his gut feeling. So how does analytics matter? I really don't understand. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. Am I audible?
No, you're not.
Right. Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Subhashish Sinha. I am from the EPGDM second batch. And my background is I have about 9 years of experience in the banking and financial services industry. Right. Before starting, my job incidentally has become slightly easier. I'll tell you why. The reason being, the topic for the day was, does analytics matter? Fortunately or unfortunately, my eminent friends have chose to speak by saying that, does analytics matter? This focus was not there. They chose to say as if analytics was the only substitute. We never wanted to make a point that analytics is the substitute for gut feeling. That is point number one. This point, the entire people who are speaking against this motion, they talked about that analytics is a substitute. If the topic is paid careful attention to, does analytics matter? That was the topic. So I will talk about does analytics matter or not, keeping in mind that it's not a substitute for intuitive logic. It's not a substitute for the experience that people would have gathered over many years. In fact, Manish talked about Malcolm Gladwell's Blink. In that very book, it talks very explicitly about a couple of things. One thing it talks about is, he does not say that intuitive logic is something which can be substituted by analytics. He says that people who were making these gut feelings had many years of research, analytical research which had been put into use. Based on those very reasons, they were able to come up with this gut feeling. Gut feeling is not something which will come up one fine morning, you wake up on the correct side of the bed and gut feeling you arrive. That is not something gut feeling is. Gut feeling is backed by proper intuition, proper experience, relevant experience over many years, and then a person is able to come up with the correct logic. So that goes about the Malcolm Gladwell's point. A couple of points which were mentioned initially. Excel, I believe Vijay talked about Excel is glorified analytics, and also Manish backed it up. Excel is a fantastic tool. Now if we introspect and sit, we'll understand the number of applications that Excel has, and the way it is used in various companies, like I would like to pardon my language, it is pathetic. Now in Excel, some companies choose to use it as an attendance sheet. Now if companies use Excel as an attendance sheet, really analytics can't help. So that's something the companies would need to decide, that if they're investing in some high-end analytical tools, whether they have the wherewithals to manage that, or they are just buying for the sake of buying. So these kind of things would need to be considered before.